Hey guys, and welcome back to a new episode of Skate 3 Park Building Tips and Tricks. First of all, a big thank you for all the support I'm getting lately. I just gained over 500 subscribers in the past week or so, and that's just amazing. So I read many comments of the last episode and collected three things you wanted to see, and those are how to make windows, curved ledges, and how to not run out of terrain space. So without further ado, let's go! So here are some window designs I came up with. These are all different kinds of windows. And the very first one is a quite old one. Most of you should know it. You just take two of these pieces and flip them like this. The second one is basically the same, just rotated by 90 degrees. And for the third one, I used this big wall banner and in a black color. And the back of this wall banner gives this shiny texture, which can make a quite good window. And how you can see, I just put some rails around it to kind of frame it. Third one is just a piece of water, again with some rails around it. And the next one is again with water tiles, but this time I flipped them like this and tilted them slightly so that I could make them any size I want to. And how you can see, you just put them like this. And then I used many rails again to frame the window. This design is also quite known. It's just this skylight wedge that again is tilted so that it can be any size I want to, with some benches around it. For the very last design, I just used this big building and used some brick walls to cover up the top and the bottom of the building. So first of all, here are two custom designs, one using this curved ledge and the other using a bunch of straight ledges that I just copied. But I wouldn't recommend these types of ledges because they are very glitchy and you can't really skate them. So here are some designs I came up with that skate really good. This first one is this brick textured one. It's just two of these pieces that you have to place in a corner. This design is also one that you have to place in a corner, but the only problem with this one is that you can't really choose any color of it because it's already red. This big one is basically this pool that I lowered down into the ground. Then you also have this very small ledge, which is more like a rail. I just used this curved bench. You can also use these big half pipes and just turn them and lower them into the ground. Or use a quarter pipe, which actually skates very good. Or you can even use a round stair set, which is also lowered to the ground. This again is a half pipe, but only a small piece of it. You actually have to hide this little thing on the other side into a wall or something. And for the last design I just used this quarter pipe that has this rusty texture. Actually looks quite good in my opinion. So how you can see, it's actually quite hard to build a curved ledge, but all of these designs do a pretty good job in my opinion, and they all skate very well. Someone asked if I could give any tips on how to not run out of terrain, because if you build a park you often run into the problem that you haven't finished your park but your terrain meter is all red. And how you can see, I just placed as many paths as I can and the whole park is filled up with them. So if I try to do the same thing with mega terrain pads, you can see I can't place that many pads. So you might think that the larger the piece is, the more terrain it will cost. But if you just place a bunch of buildings which are actually quite large, the terrain meter won't be affected that much. So that theory is wrong. After trying out a lot of stuff, I came to the conclusion that all objects can be put into these three categories. The first one being rails, ledges and foliage. These items won't take that much of the terrain meter. The second one being pre-made terrain, street terrain, vert terrain, plaza terrain, branding and downtown. You can still place a big amount of these objects, and then finally mega terrain, mixed terrain and world terrain. These objects will fill up the terrain meter very fast, so I don't recommend using that many of these objects. How you can see, I only placed 60 sharks and my terrain meter is completely red. So I hope you enjoyed this episode of Skate 3 park building tips and tricks. If you have any questions, just ask in the comment section below, I will surely answer all of them. Also, if you have any suggestions for my next video, just write a comment. And yeah, if you enjoyed it, be sure to drop a like and subscribe for more Skate 3 videos. And I'll see you in the next video. Bye!